Welcome to this new episode. In this episode, we will discuss about the synchronization of the backend changes in the running CR. Let's go to the next presentation and check the use case. So let's say that the material or the business partner is locked in the change request by the business user. And at the same time, someone from the quality team or any other team is updating this master data using the backend T-codes or LSMW or data migration cockpit or even mass T-codes. So now when the business user clicks on the check button in the change request, they will get a warning message saying that there is a change in the reuse active area. So depending on your workflow configuration, CR activation will fail. And so now the business user has two options. One is they can reject the CR. Otherwise, they can manually synchronize these changes in the running CR. If they fail to do these two activities, then the CR activation will fail depending on your workflow configuration. So because there is a snapshot, difference exists now. And in many cases, I've seen that, people configured the fallback user. So if there is any activation failure, it goes to the fallback user, and this fallback user, they have an option to bypass the snapshot. So when they bypass the snapshot, of course, this, CR data will override the backend changes. In this case, the backend changes are lost. This is not most of the time a preferred approach. So in MDG 2023 FSP1, SAP introduced a new feature. With that, you can able to synchronize the backend changes also in the running CR. So they introduced this feature as part of the recent customer connection program. And this is available in the MDG 2023 FSP1 stock. So if you're not running in MDG 2023, you need to install the following SNOS. To avail this feature, you need to first configure the BGRPC, and then you have to activate the business transaction event. And this feature is available for the business partner and then the material master. Of course, not for the financial model because it is a flex model, and also not for the custom data models. So let's go into the system and then configure the BGRPC, and then we can activate the business transaction event. So let's first check the error. To do that, go to PFCG and then, I should click on the display. Let's log the material in the change request. So click run button. I would like to take this one. There is already a CR. Let's reject the CR. Okay, so withdraw the CR. Okay, the CR is now fine check rejected. Okay. So now click search. The CR is now removed. Okay, CR is now removed. Let's open the material. Click on the search material. Open the material and lock it in the change request. Okay, so now click on the edit button on the top and then select the CR type. So click import S, and then let me update the division to 02 or leave it like this. Just simply capture the material in the change request and click on the save button. So now the material is locked in the change request. Now go to the backend and try to update the material master using the T-code MM02. So let me say I'm going to update the old material number. Click save button. Now go to the change request, click refresh, click on the check button. So now you get an error message saying that the old material number changed from 0 to this value in the reuse active area, and it is also highlighted here. Yeah. So now, as I said, the business user have two options. One is to reject this here. Otherwise, they can click on the edit button and then manually input this value. But with MDG 2023, this will automatically synchronize as soon as there is an update in the backend. So yeah, to check that, first, we need to activate the BJFC. So let's go and activate the BJFC. And before to that, cancel the CR. Okay, the change request is canceled now. Okay, there is no change request. Open change request here. Okay, so now to activate for material master, go to BF11 T code and then open the business transaction event MDG CRU and click on the activate button and save it. Okay, so now the configuration is done for the material master. And to do for a business partner, go to the T code bupa underscore call underscore fu and then look for the event bp, sorry, bp out. Okay, so here is the event. So if it is not there, simply click on the new entries and add it. So this is BP out and this is the item number. This is the function module and click on the activate. And then click on the save button. Okay, so as I said, the first thing we should have done the BJFC, but somehow I forgot. So let's go and activate, you know, configure the BJFC. To do that, paste BJFC con, you know, conf T code, and then include the inbound destination name. Click on the create button, and then the inbound destination name is nothing but the MTG underscore snapshot underscore refresh, and then the queue name is MDG underscore snapshot, and then click on the add button, click on the save button, and then click on the save button. So sometimes I forget here, so make sure you click on the save button here, otherwise it won't be saved. If there is no BJFC, it will not synchronize. Yeah, so if we, so even if you have activated the business transaction event and the CR is not synchronized with the background changes, then come and check the BJFC. Most cases it will be, you know, sometimes removed automatically. I don't know the reason. Okay. Okay, so now you clicked on the save button, but in most cases it won't be removed automatically. You know, it was my mistake that, you know, I didn't click save button and then I went and checked it, then it didn't work. After that I came back and added once again this BJFC and clicked save button, then it worked. Okay, so now the BJFC is configured, also the business transaction event is configured. So now let's log this material in the change request once again. Okay, so now click on the edit button on the top and select the CR type, and then input division from 01 to 02 and then click save button. Okay, so now go to the backend M02, open the material once again. So it also synchronized the old material number. Yeah, it didn't synchronize because we logged the change request, logged this material in the change request after updating this change. So that's why it is showing. So now let's say that you are updating to some other value. And then lab office, let me select something. some value, and then class plan status. Let me select 000. Okay, so after you added all these details, let's change the division also. You see that I have changed to 02. Let's change to 03 and see what happens. And then click save button. Okay, it is saved. Usually when you click save button, the function module will be executed. So you can also put a breakpoint and check it. So basically this function module is executed using the workflow user. So don't forget to put the workflow user ID if you wanted to debug. Okay, so now we saved it. Now go to the CR and then click refresh button, and you see that the background changes are synchronized, but here you see the division is not synchronized. So this is the cache. If the user changes the field in the CR, then this field won't be synchronized. This is most of the time accepted cases. In case if you have a requirement where this should also be overwritten from the backend changes, then you have to enhance it. I hope guys this might have been very useful for you, and then I will come back with another video, and I wish you all a very nice day, and thank you so much for watching this video.